The Order of the Honourable Annette King.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. You know, today, Women's Suffrage Day was a chance for the government to put up some strong women speakers, to praise the women of New Zealand, to congratulate them on 119 years since we received the vote and the work that women have done in this country. But what did we get from the National Party? We got Crusher Collins, who stood up and insulted everybody. And then we got the member for Tauranga, whose only role in this House is to have patsy questions asked about issues that no one has any interest in. Lots of insults, yelling, ranting and raving. Well, I want to say that some of us are celebrating women's suffrage today. And I started with a celebratory breakfast in good company and lively discussion, because 119 years since New Zealand women got the vote is worth celebrating. We were the first country in the world to give women the vote. And it's something that we as a nation have been particularly proud of. And you only need to look at a country like Switzerland that didn't give women the vote until 1971 to know that New Zealand has been a leader in social and economic reforms throughout our history. Only need to go back to the first Labor government of 1935, which put in place our health system, our social security, our education system, and much of it has survived today, even though we've had periodic attacks by right-wing governments in the past. We've been international leaders in many issues: nuclear-free New Zealand, smoke-free legislation, human rights legislation. So for a small country, we continue to show leadership in many fields, driven by a committed, compassionate and determined Kiwis. But Mr. Speaker, it is not good enough to wallow in the past or to rest on our achievements built up by others who have been prepared to make the right decisions. It is time to look to the future for New Zealand women, to look forward, say, 50 years. A 15-year-old young girl today would be going into retirement. And I know that some politicians in this House like to live in three-year election cycles and to find out if they can get themselves back into power. But we should start looking at the growing signs that we have of future problems that are appearing right now that are going to affect young women in the future. And one of them has to be the cost and the availability of housing for single women. There has been a rise in homelessness for women. Women sleeping rough in the streets, not just in the big cities of Auckland and Wellington, but in places like Nelson. And the warning signals are being sent out by those social agencies right now. They are the people who are on the street who are seeing what is happening day by day. For decades, we have had homelessness amongst men. We've accommodated them in night shelters. But now we have a new problem emerging: homelessness amongst single women of all ages. In fact, the problem has got so big in Nelson, the Salvation Army is undertaking a major piece of work to focus on why single women are becoming homeless and what plans they could have for housing in the future. And they've found increasing numbers of single women are sleeping in cars, couch surfing, or in short-term hostels. And one of the reasons they have found is housing affordability. It is getting worse. There are fewer low-income homes available. Here in Wellington, there's a growing number of homeless women, and it's been put down once again to the cost of housing, a housing shortage and a lack of jobs. And contrary to the popular belief, many of these women are well-educated women. They're not the stereotypical dropout, check-out of society that some people may think. Look forward 50 years, Mr. Speaker, and we're looking at women living to almost 89 years of age, that women will retire on less superannuation than men, that women will still have student loans outstanding when they retire, and many of them will not own their own home at retirement age. Combine that with the growing crisis of a lack of affordable housing. And Mr. Speaker, the picture is one of poverty in older New Zealanders, particularly in women, in the not too distant future. Is that a legacy we want to leave to the women of New Zealand?
Honourable Amy Adams.
Thank you.